The intellectual atheist claims that he's done away with the need for God. But in reality, he's created for himself this pantheon of his own gods.
Seriously?
The three supreme deities being the god of natural selection.
No. Natural selection is an observation. It's not God, it's observed fact.
The god of time.
Wait, are you saying time doesn't exist? Or are you saying we worship time somehow?
And the god of spontaneous generation.
No one believes in spontaneous generation anymore. Knock it off.
Now, Winnie's questioned how an amoeba could, say, turn into an ape.
Amoebas didn't turn into apes. Learn how evolution works before opening your ignorant mouth.
Or a molecule into a man.
Wow, you really don't know anything about this, do you?
He invokes his first god. Well, Mother Nature selects.
Citation needed, bro.
And natural selection, along with mutations, will just bring about this change.
Since the changes you posited are straw man that no evolutionary biologist believes, you're just lying! Mutation and natural selection are how life diversifies. And it's solid and incredibly well-founded, even more so than gravity. Which is why you have to make up lies like this! You can't refute what it really says!
When he's questioned why we've never seen this transformation from one kind of a creature into another.
We have! There are numerous examples of speciation, and we keep observing more and more over and over again. All you do is repeat this lie, insisting on using the word kind instead of the word species, so you can just redefine it after the fact. We've seen this for decades. No one with a brain is falling for it anymore.
He invokes his second god. Just give it enough time, he claims, and time will somehow work its magic.
Again, citation needed. You're just making up crap with no citations to back it up.
When he's questioned how life first began, he places his faith in the supernatural god of spontaneous generation.
No, it's abiogenesis. You keep renaming it to spontaneous generation to try and associate it with a previously debunked and completely unrelated theory.
You see, eons ago, life suddenly and accidentally popped into existence.
Not what they claim either. For a good example of abiogenesis research, check out the work of Dr. Jack Szostak. He's demonstrated the spontaneous formation of stable vesicles under conditions that existed in the early Earth, and he's also demonstrated how nucleotides can become captured and selected. He's even demonstrated a primitive version of cell division using nothing more than the mechanical forces and simple convection currents near hydrothermal vents. So what's your response to that? You don't have one, do you?
He attempts to patch each unobservable phenomenon of his theory.
They have been observed. Deal with it.
Building out a pantheon of supernatural deities and invoking miracles based not on laws, physics, or scientific principles, but on faith.
You know, it's funny. Not only do you lie and say that these scientifically demonstrated phenomena are miracles not based on laws of physics, even though they're not miraculous and are absolutely based on the laws of physics and chemistry, but you also try to say that they're using faith, and in the process, you use the word faith as a pejorative. So clearly, you know that faith is bogus, and the only reason you're doing any of this is cognitive dissonance.
A faith that seems to be clung to with the fervor and even religiosity of the most devout evangelist. An unquestioned faith in his beliefs that, when challenged, is met with hatred, disdain, and pompous arrogance.
Then why does that never happen when scientific papers re-examine each other? Why didn't it happen to, for example, Dr. Lynn Margulis when she posited endosymbiosis for the origin of eukaryotic cells, a non-Darwinian process? How was she eventually able to get her theory into textbooks? I'll tell you how. She demonstrated it. She made scientific tests that confirmed it. And other scientists redid those tests and came to the same conclusion. If there were any truth to your Bronze Age delusions, you could do the same thing. But you don't. Why is that? Maybe because you know that every time someone does, it fails and fails and fails again?
and this set of principles that he believes by faith and clings to so reverently is only a temple or a shrine to his gods built on a foundation of sand.
Another example of someone using so many words to say absolutely nothing.
As long as it remains unchallenged.
But it's not unchallenged. It's challenged all the time in actual scientific papers published in actual scientific journals. And the results are all sorts of extra-Darwinian processes, like epigenetics, epistasis, polyphenism, pleiotropy, phenotypic plasticity, and many others. Darwin's original concepts are just a tiny part of evolutionary biology today. And yet, you're acting like scientists treat Darwin like some kind of god that can't be refuted. Well, tell me this. Why hasn't science accepted gemmule theory? That was Darwin's proposal for how traits become inherited, which was discarded in favor of Mendelian inheritance. Why? Because that's what the evidence showed!
You know, his unfaltering blind faith in miraculous gods of nature is, dare I say it, his religion. Where do you place your faith?
I place my faith in creationists being liars, because that's proven to be as consistent as the sunrise.
Truly, the heavens declare the glory of God.
Prove it or shut your lying mouth! Hey, thanks for watching. Please hit like and subscribe and keep these videos coming by donating, becoming a subscriber and getting special benefits, or even for free with airtime. And check out all the great content here, like this video selected just for you.